Omaha is a services town. If you're looking to move fiber for, or communications or telephone, we are the edge. So that's the reason the hyperscaler here. So there, if you're going east coast to west coast, this is a great place to say, okay, I'm going to go north or south from here. Or I'm going to propagate data from here so I don't have to keep repeating it or trying to push it. Data has gravity. Data will slow down. So a good stopping part is what people call the flyover area of Omaha. It's not just passing data through Omaha to get to other carriers or to pick up one carrier and move over to another, but actually placing content here and having the caching happen is a big part of what, where the internet, where data centers are going. A lot of providers use Omaha or this facility as their hub. I was aware of this facility and it needed a hug. It needed to be redone. It was a mess. We remodeled this, put those generators in during COVID. We were all working. We had 125 people a day working in this building, but it was a very complex build out. The design is meant to make you think, is that the building or is that a stack of servers? It's kind of fun that it makes people ask that question. So it makes people want to go a little deeper, dig a little deeper. So it was, it's working by, as designed. I'm a born and raised Omaha person that's been doing data centers back in the times where I started, and we had several generators that were cats. I eventually, through my career, became in charge of operations globally, and we used CAT because I'd had a good experience. So the Nebraska machine, where we would travel as we did projects all over the U.S., all over the world, and CAT was my preferred go-to. In our case, we're in a downtown environment, so having generators that were very quiet was super important, not just for city code, but they also needed to be quiet because we have residential condos, apartments right next to the structure that our generators sit on. One thing I was worried about in the whole project was probably that we were going to be able to make that code, because at night it had to be 65 dB or less at the property line. Never had anybody that could even show me I was even close to being higher than we should be. So we're a good neighbor. There was a crane process involved. It was a pretty extensive pick to be able to put these up on top of this building. So you're four stories up. So the weight, you can imagine, of the enclosure, the generator, the coordination with the suppliers, the crane crew, the general contractor, what exactly were we putting up here? Was it going to weigh? It wasn't just the generators, it's the switchgear, and you're doing it for multiple generators. You're trying to get it done over a very short window because of the cost for a crane and weather that you're trying to manage. We had downtown streets, multiple lanes closed to be able to have this pick happen. So everybody had to know the specific details, and you couldn't be wrong. If you were within a few percentage points off, the pick was going to be canceled. So it was super important that everybody was a contributor in CAT. We never had to wait for the data. The data was accurate, and we felt really good about what we got. CAT 3512C is our choice because of the weight and the size on top of the installation we had to do. So we looked at other models, but this particular model works best for sound, noise we had to manage, and it's a great backup for our building. It's super reliable and it's efficient. The customer value agreement that CAT offers is really important for us to be able to have their crew, Nebraska Machinery, come out on behalf of CAT and maintain our generators. They know what filters we're going to need. They know what specific hoses we might have issues with. And they keep an eye on any kind of a leak that would come up or any kind of maintenance that's just normal annual, semi-annual maintenance. And they know our facility. They know us. They know how we use them and the importance they are to our facility, and they treat them accordingly. Nebraska Machinery is a big dealer. They know how to, specifically in this case, do generators in a downtown environment. They're used to getting into tight spots. They're used to delivering them in second story, third story roofs, and they'll work with you. So very responsive. If you call, they answer, and they work with you as a partnership. And there's things that sometimes we don't know or they don't know, and we work together to figure it out. So really, really a good vendor, good partner, super top shelf is what I'd say, right there with the brand.